हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। मायसेल्फ राइस गुप्ता, पीजीटी फिजिक्स, केबी नंबर 2, जयपुर। इन दिस चैप्टर नंबर 2 वी विल डिस्कस इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल। इन इट द फोर कॉन्सेप्ट्स आर हियर: इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल एंड पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस, इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल ड्यू टू ए सिंगल पॉइंट चार्ज, इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल due to a group of charges, and electric potential due to an electric dipole on axial as well as equatorial line. Just as filling a glass with water increases its level, same, just as heating a body increases its temperature, similarly, charging a body increases its potential. So we are going to discuss what is electric potential. Electric potential is a physical quantity which determines the flow of charge from one body to another. This quantity is also termed as degree of electrification of a body, and it is defined as the electric field. It is defined as the burden in moving a unit positive charge from infinity to given point against electrostatic force, irrespective of the path followed. On a unit positive test charge. So, according to definition, electric potential is the burden from infinity to given point per unit positive test charge. Its SI unit is volt or joule per coulomb. From here you can define 1 volt, 1 joule of work is done in moving 1 coulomb of charge from infinity to given point in the electric field. Now, same as electric potential, you can also define electric potential difference. Both terms are similar, but in the case of electric potential difference, here we are taking 2 points, but in the case of electric potential, we take the 1 point as infinity, another point in the given field. So electric potential difference between any 2 points in the electric field is the amount of work required to bring a unit positive test charge from one point to another in the electrostatic field, irrespective of the path followed, without acceleration. So we remember electric potential and electric potential difference are scalar quantities. And also remember, electric potential at infinity is zero, means there is no electrostatic force at infinity, so no charge can exist any force there. And electric potential is positive for positive charge and negative for negative charge. Its CGS unit is also as state volt. So potential difference is defined as burden between 2 points in the field of source charge per unit positive test charge. Now we will discuss the important article, that is electric potential due to a single point charge and its derivation. So first of all, we take the source charge and we assume that the test charge is at infinity. Now we are taking this test charge from infinity to given point P. So here in this mechanics or the diagram, it is clear that the charge, that is test charge here Q naught, and source charge here is plus Q. And we are taking up to R, means at the point B. So Q naught be the test charge placed at the point P at a distance x from the source charge Q. So the force F equals to Q naught E is radially outward, which tends to accelerate the test charge. To prevent this acceleration, equal and opposite force minus Q naught E has to be applied on the test charge. So work done, that is dW, that is F vector dot dx, by moving test charge between points P and Q is F vector dot dx vector. After solving, we get minus Q naught E dx, but electric field is KQ by x square at the distance of x, when we take here test charge at the point P. So total work done to move test charge Q naught from A to B is infinity to B point whole integration. So it is equal to minus infinity to R Q Q naught by 4 pi epsilon naught x square dx. And after solving this integration, we get KQ by R. And here, if we plot the graph between electric potential and distance of observation for positive charge, the graph comes in first quadrant. And if we plot for negative charge, the graph comes in the fourth quadrant. Now, electric potential due to a group of point charges means we are taking 1 coulomb of charge, and nearby we are taking number of charge Q1, Q2, Q3 up to Qn. Now, net potential at the point P is the scalar sum of all the potential at the point P. So we can solve it and we get K summation I 1 to N Qi upon Ri, where Qi, I stand for 1 to N, and same K is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. You can also take in position vector form. Now, so overall what we observe here, the potential is inversely proportional to distance of observation. And electric potential is always a scalar quantity here. Now, electric potential due to an electric dipole. So here are two cases, first on axial line, second on equatorial line. So on axial line, the axial line is that line which joins the charges in the same direction. So here we take the observation point B from the center of the dipole, which is x distance apart. Now, the potential due to plus Q charge is KQ upon x minus L as per the formula KQ by R. Same way for minus Q charge, it is minus KQ upon x plus L, because electric potential is a scalar. So you have to add just like a scalar form. So after adding, we get K Q into 2L upon x square minus L square. So here Q into 2L is electric dipole moment. So we get electric potential on axial line KP upon x square minus L square. For short dipole, it is comes out KP upon x square, means x is greater than L. Now, if we calculate on second on equatorial line, so equatorial line is that line which bisects the dipole. So observation point here is Q, which is by distance apart, and we have to calculate the electric potential due to minus Q and plus Q charge. So due to minus Q charge, again same formula we have to use, KQAR. So due to plus Q charge, it is comes out KQ upon BQ. BQ is the distance of separation between observation point and plus Q charge. So again, we have to calculate minus Q and plus Q charge, the net potential, that is again a scalar sum. So distance is same, charge are nature opposite, so net potential is comes out zero. So we remember electric potential on equatorial line is always zero. Now we come across assignments questions. So first question, we are taking draw graph between electric potential and distance of observation due to positive and negative point charge Q. So here we have already discussed this question in the theory part. So graph you can draw here, which is first quadrant and fourth quadrant you are observing, you know. Now question number two, a hollow metallic sphere of radius 5 cm is charged such that the potential on its surface is 5 volt, but the potential at the center of the sphere. So you know that from center to surface the potential remains same, so its value will 5 volt. Question number three, give the dependence of electrostatic potential due to a small electric dipole at a far off point lying on first axial line, second at equatorial line. So the answer on axial line, that is Kp upon x square minus l square, if the x is the distance of observation and 2l is the dipole length. Similarly on equatorial line, it is comes out zero. Question number four, name a physical quantity whose SI unit is joule per coulomb. Is it a scalar or vector quantity? So joule per coulomb means it is electric potential and it is a scalar quantity. Now question number five, so 2 point charges 4 microcoulomb and -2 microcoulomb are separated by a distance of 1 meter. At what point on the line joining the two charges is the electric potential zero? So it can be calculated as KQIR formula. So you can take x distance from 4 microcoulomb charge, so remaining distance is 1 minus x from -2 microcoulomb, and if you compare or the net charge, net potential, sorry, so it is comes out x equals to 2/3 meter. So from the 4 microcoulomb. Thank you.